said already, very stiff design. This is from Mando, from our Korean supplier. It's nothing fancy, but we tuned it in a way that it does a really good job. So we developed special logics, especially in combination with a limited slip differential, as you know. Yeah, also then to avoid too much of torque steer, we have a nice corner acceleration compensation logic in there. And all to an extent where it still feels very natural, not annoying, not artificial. And yeah, this afternoon you can come up with your own evaluation about this. Tire development, it's the same story. This is not like a cup tire or something. This is a pretty good all-rounder. The Pirelli P0 19 inch, it's a unique development. It works well in the cold, it works well in the wet. It lasts pretty long, but still it's a damn good tire. You can sense this later on out there. But we didn't go to the extreme because, yeah, this is also the everyday practical sports car. And especially for the Veloster N, we developed a unique tire. It's different from the i30N. Yeah, the sidewall is more robust. So the pinching risk, if you think about East Coast, New York, the big potholes, yeah, this is an issue. Of course, we could have a really fancy tire on the car, but how long can it survive in these road conditions? So especially for Korea and the US, we made this special tire development. We think it's still very nice matching with the rest of the car, but if we didn't take the extreme, we didn't go to 20 inch, for example, because we know this fun is over very soon. You know, you cannot be aware of all the potholes out there. Yeah, so this was a very good development. We got very good support from Pirelli here. The base car is on 18 inch Michelin Pilot Supersport, also a very nice car. Today we only offer the performance package on the Pirelli P0. Yeah, so then doing the corner ESC control, especially in Nürburgring, the most famous corner is probably the carousel, and there are cars out there where the ESC control, because of the banking in the corner, brings the car to almost a full stop. So we have an extra logic in our ESC to avoid that. So there's no issue in the carousel, you can go down in, full power, no problem, the car can take it easily. So for especially the standard spec car, we developed intensely with our Mobis ESC. It's a Mobis ESC, even not the latest and greatest we have in Mobis, our sister company, but we added a few functions. So the torque vectoring by brake, we apply here much more intense than in any other car of Hyundai. So, and it works pretty well on the standard car, and we are relying a little bit more on the standard car without the ELSD on the torque vectoring than we do on the performance package car with the limited slip differential. And also, although we have a really pretty stiff McPherson strut design, still, if you go really to the limit, you always get a little bit of knockback from the disc to the pistons of the front calipers. So we have a pre-fill system that compensates for that. So when you come to the next corner, we avoid the long pedal with this extra logic. It works pretty well. You cannot notice that extra function in there. It works pretty good. Yeah, then this is our first ever own development of an electronically controlled limited slip differential. We did this together with our sister company, VIA. And there was a time, maybe before the i30 launch, 1 year before, I was still doubting if we can really get it to the point. I have to say, we learned so many things and we made so big improvements. So when we launched the i30N, we delivered a really nice balanced ELSD system. It's out there now for some time and we are really happy with the performance. We have different modes for the ELSD, also customizable and the N custom mode. And it's very precise, it's very consistent. It's an electro-hydraulic system. Others use electromechanical multiplate systems. We think our system is more consistent, it's more precise, we can control the kiss point better, and we are pretty happy with it. We call it our end corner carving differential. Yeah, in some corners when you accelerate, you get this nice carving feel. It's not too intense, yeah, it's not annoying, but you can sense it nicely takes you through the corner, and it adds to the driving fun. it makes the car also a little bit faster. But the driving fun, that was the key element, and yeah, we tuned it, first of all, to give it more fun and excitement. So, shock absorbers, we use our Mando electronically controlled shock absorber system. We use the same system in other cars, Genesis, for example. It's a very nice system, it's very nice tunable, and it has a lot of sensors, three body sensors, two wheel side sensors, and we have many functions in it. So independent road control, front and rear pitch control, but also the valving, the basics, the hydraulics with this valve system can be very good. And this is, I think, the most important thing, that the hydraulic basis is really good. And on top then, we have the different drive modes. And this is also a key element to make this a practical everyday sports car. So we have a wide range from normal mode, sport mode, into N mode. And yeah, you can try easily. We have those mode buttons on the steering wheel. So the bright performance blue buttons, the left one goes eco, normal, sport. The right one goes N, and if you push the N again, you get N custom. And custom, then you can freely configure everything what's in there to your liking. But yeah, make sure this doesn't distract you when you are out there on the track. So maybe, yeah, take a really safe section in the driving when you start playing around with this. And this is why we put those buttons on the steering wheel. Yeah, you can automatically control. You don't need to take your eye from the road. You can easily control those buttons. And yeah, it's all customizable, like the ref matching. It's also in there. So we have throttle control. We have the sound control with the exhaust system. We have the limited slip. We can control ESC, shock absorber, steering, and one more. So seven features in the performance package car we can control with our customizing system. Yeah, then, yeah, the sound, of course, the sound is important to give the excitement. Also, our end story is to bring the excitement of a motorsport, of a race car, into everyday's driving. And, of course, sound is a big portion of emotion of driving a race car. 10 of you, the 10 lucky guys, can get the full blast of motorsport excitement this afternoon. And we tried to bring some of this into everyday's driving, and the N button and the N mode does a damn good job on that. Yeah. So we get very good feedback from our customers about this. And we have different control applications for the different modes. Yeah, then yeah, we tested the car even in the 24 hours. So in 2017, we only tested the powertrain, the motor, the engine and the transmission in the old car, in the old i30. And then last year we put like pre-production cars in the 24-hour race, and it was fascinating. One car had no accidents, and the only thing that got to have fuel and tires and brakes and drivers, and that was it. And the other car got the same, but he also got 4 hours of repair. So that made a poor position, but we finished 50s overall out of 160 cars. It was an almost production car. We only drove bigger brakes in the front, basically. Everything else was an almost production car. That was a very impressive result. We even educated some of our young Korean engineers, and they got the Nordschleife permit, so they were participating. One of them was even participating this year in the TCR racing with the i30N TCR. So, and also did a great job there. So the N enthusiasm is also growing a lot for our engineers. So I want to introduce some of our engineers here. So there's Klaus Köster. He's heading the development of N here in Rüsselsheim. And then we have John Ramsey. He does all the magic and the welding of shock absorbers and bump stoppers and so on. We have Des and Kim. He is a key person from Namyang in the body development. And then we have Jian Zhang. He is coordinating between Rüsselsheim and Namyang. So we have a very intense collaboration between the N in Namyang and the N in Nürburgring. where our engineers, most of the time they are in Rüsselsheim, but the tuning guys, the test engineers, they spend almost more time here in the test center. And when we have our testing sessions, many Korean engineers also come here. And that is also an interesting part of the whole N story, that we have this combination of Korean young, very motivated, very well-educated engineers, and we have some European guys, and that mix, that is also maybe one part of our success story. Why this car is so strong. We have this combination, and that seems to be very powerful. So thank you for your attention. We'll be right back.